as the dominant and more extreme version of Islam has over. Please see the Quran so to know where Haidu's extremism sources from. The political system plays with the collective memory of the people we see in Pakistan. Let me first put this in the historical perspective. Greece and India refer to state entities that existed in their geopolitical sphere before their neighbors. Turkey and Pakistan are results of invention, conversions, and breakaways. What's more, there are few exceptions of societies that although they follow Islam, the states are secular, like Lebanon and Albania. This is not the case of India and Turkey. In both countries, let's be honest, the dominant and more extreme version of Islam has over. Please see the Quran so to know where Haidu's extremism sources from. The political system plays with the collective memory of the people. We see in Pakistan that Hindus, Christians, and even Kalasa are being discriminated against and often persecuted. We see the tiny Christian and Jewish minorities in Turkey to be targeted. Both the state and paramilitary organizations attack religious minorities in Turkey for centuries. The religious minorities of Turkey were accused publicly even for no kidding coronavirus. We saw how the Turkish leadership did with turning Hagia Sophia into a mosque. We saw Imran Khan not losing time to hail this. Both Turkey and Pakistan export instability. Pakistan tries to intervene in India, be it Jammu and Kashmir, be it elsewhere. It has managed to destroy Afghanistan by supporting the Taliban, who, by the way, prioritized the destruction of the remnants of the Indo-Greek Bactrian civilization. See what Turkey does to Cyprus, Syria, Armenia, you name it. They are what in international relations is described as reformist actors. And as George Bush would describe, it is the true axis of evil. We are aware that Turkey tries to become a nuclear power. There is a broad discussion whether nuclear weapons should exist in the first place, because a large-scale nuclear war can annihilate the mankind and perhaps life on Earth as we know it. But as they do exist, they at least should be owned by sober powers that own them in order to defend international order. I cannot hide the fact that I fear that one fanatic Sunni state, Pakistan, already owns nuclear weapons. I believe that Pakistan doesn't want to give away the right of being the only Sunni state with nuclear weapons, but I am afraid that they will eventually leak somehow to Turkey. I repeat it, countries that have such fanatic regimes must not own this force. No one can guarantee who the next Imran Khan will be and how we want to deal with the kafir, the infidels, be it Hindus, Christians or Buddhists. I hope and I have personally tried to create a European reaction to Turkey owning nuclear weapons. Turkey wants to bully way more countries than it actually does. I believe that the international system won't allow this. USA has already showed the way. In his internal policies, Erdogan does something useful for his country. He sets targets and pushes his people to dream of the future and perhaps forget the actual bad state of their personal finance. As it goes for yoga, so it's the politics. Visualization is helpful. Erdogan feeds caliphate to the Turkish people. This leads to the elders speak about the past and the younger ones suffer the present so to move to a future. Honestly, this is royal manipulation. Turkey won't grow for three reasons. First, it has reached its maximum. History shows that over expansion is followed by decline. Second, it loses the allies in the Arab world who can see that they can cooperate and do business with Israel. Third, the Kurdish community grows 2.5 times faster than the currently Turks. Currently, 1 out of 5 Turkish citizens are Kurdish. Some estimates bring Kurds to become majority in Turkey by 2050. It is clear that soon there won't be possible to to have a Turkish government without a Kurdish element in it. According to two reports by Indian Security Service, Turkey is investing in the radicalization of Indian Muslims. I believe this is because it wants to offer a service to Pakistan. Through the activities of a former ISIS executive, Turkey aims at transferring know-how for a large-scale destabilization in India. It feeds the growth of the radicalized Islam communities in India through the state-controlled media, educational institutes, and NGOs. I would like to thank you very much, and it was my pleasure to participate in this meeting.